So for this problem, we have to find out what is the moment around x-axis. So this is the moment around an axis problem, which means the first equation you are going to think about will be a triple product. U dot R cross F. So what we have to do is think about what is the U, what is R, what is F we are going to use. So the U here will be the unit vector of the axis you want to calculate, which means in our case, that will be the x-axis, right? So that will be just I hat. And now let's move to the R. So what is the R in the moment around an axis? Is any point from the axis to any point on the force action line, which means we are going to have a lot of options here. So we can use ROA, can we? Any point on the axis, which is O, to any point on the force action line. So you might ask me, can I use ROB? Yes, you can, as long as it satisfies the definition. For example, if we mark this location as C, can we have other options here? Yes, we can. We can use RCA. And we can also use RCB. And for some students, in order to do the easy calculation, some students even want to use this as the R. So it starts from any point on the axis we want to calculate to any point on the force action line, which means this R here will be for K. All of them can be option. You just need to choose one of them in your calculation. You should be fine. So now, the last thing we have to do is try to find out what is the force factor. Again, we know the magnitude, so which means it will be magnitude multiply the unit vector of the force action line. So the unit vector will be VA. So in order to find out what is the unit vector of VA, we have to find out the location of A and B. So for this problem here, what I am going to do, I am going to choose the pink line as my R and use this combination to solve the problem. As we talked about before, we have to gather the location of A and B so that we can calculate the unit vector from B to A. So the location for A will be 3, 0, 4. So what is the location at B? So you can see it's in the YZ plane. So X will be 0. And then the length for this edge will be 3 feet. So which means the Y coordinate system will be 3 multiply cosine 20. And we can use the geometry, try to find out the Z location too. 3 sine 20 degree. So now, let's try to write the force in the vector form. So that will be the 20, the magnitude, multiply the unit vector. So which means it will be equals to 20 multiply the position vector unitized. So Remember, we are going to use end point minus the start point, right? So which means the position vector will be 3i minus 3 cosine 20 degree. And then we try to unitize everything and multiply the magnitude. And finally, we are going to find out the force vector will be this. Now it's ready to calculate moment around x-axis. Remember, it will be a triple product, u dot r cross f. And as we explained before, the unit vector will be the axis we want to calculate. Right now it's x-axis, so which means it will be 1, 0, 0. And the r, we are going to use the pink line, so which means it will be 0, 0, 4. You can try to use OA or OB, CA or CB. We are going to get the same answer. And the third row is going to be the force vector we just calculate. And working on this matrix, you can see we can cross out this line. And finally, that's the matrix we are going to left. So which means we can finally find out the moment around x-axis will be 44.4 pound feet.